Dimitri and Tornabene, a GDQ-based study of the mixed mode interfacial response of composite specimens with a curved geometry.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. The main topic of this talk is about a numerical study for the mixed mode interfacial response of composite specimens with a generally curved geometry. And this work has been performed at the University of Salento in collaboration with Professor Francesco Tornabene. And as you know, the mixed mode fracture mechanics problems and the closed form solutions for non-flat interfaces and adherence with complex materials and geometries are very cumbersome to be approached, despite their great importance for many practical engineering applications, as you can see here. And in this concern, we aim at studying generally shaped composite specimens subjected to an axial, transverse, and bending loading conditions at one side and clamped to the other one. And please note that the proposed numerical approach, the GDQ approach, generalized differential quadrature approach, enables any kind of boundary condition or loading condition applied on the specimen with a certain flexibility, let me say, avoiding any theoretical closed form computation, both in terms of stress of energy parameters. As you can see here, for example, the same numerical approach could be used also to model simply supported curved beams with a vertical loaded distribution, no? As you can see here in some practical examples of composite arch bridge systems. And let's reconsider our mechanical model. So our case where we consider a layered curved specimen made by two orthotropic sublaminates of general shape, modeled as Timoshenko beams, partly cracked and partly connected by an elastic brittle interface with the elastic constants, both in mode one and mode two, I mean in the longitudinal and in the orthogonal direction. And according to a classical lamination approach, the sublaminates can be modeled as homogeneous equivalent beams, where we have to introduce the following equivalent stiffness you can see here. And we have to define the equilibrium equations for each sublaminate, at least in the adhesive portion. We have then to define, to introduce the constitutive laws for each arm, where together with the boundary conditions. And by combination of all these relations, we get to the following set of differential equations, which are written in a coupled sense. I mean, this set of equations are all expressed by means of the kinematic quantities, both in mode one and mode two, in the longitudinal and orthogonal direction, in a coupled sense. So this set of equations is very difficult to be solved in a closed form solution, in a closed form. And here we provide just a closed form solutions for a simple case. I mean, a straight orthotropic double cantilever beam when the radius of curvature tends to infinite. In this case, we have to apply a suitable change of variables where the interfacial stresses are selected as a primary unknowns. And after a long mathematical manipulation, I don't have the time to discuss about, at the end, we have the following set of relations which are uncoupled and easily to be solved. And after integration, we can obtain the closed form solution for the interfacial stresses, as well as for the internal forces and the kinematic quantities, as you can see here. Or in the same manner, we can find the closed form solutions or also for all the other quantities in a static and energy sense, which are required to define appropriately the failure criterion to follow the delamination process. And as far as the numerical solution is concerned, the fundamental system of equations together with the boundary conditions can be easily solved in a discrete form by applying the GDQ technique, which discretizes the nth order of derivative of a function as a weighting linear sum of the functional values at some fixed collocation points by means of the weighting coefficients as determined through the recursive formula from the literature. And here are the discretized governing equations of the problem, together with the discretized form for the boundary condition and the constitutive laws. And in a context where the placement of grid points within the domain can affect significantly the accuracy of results, we start the numerical study with a convergence analysis by considering the traction vector along the adhesive interface defined by means of its normal and tangential components, and compute the L2 norm of the error, as you can see here, for different discretizations. Here are the plots in a b-logarithmic way, where you can see the very fast rate of convergence of the numerical solutions for the different discretizations, where it is required a very limited number of collocation points ranging from 65 to 81 in our case, to obtain a very accurate results. So in the following, we continue to consider this optimum number of collocation points equal to 65 for our analysis. So now we extend the numeric analysis of the adhesive interface response to curved members with a constant and varying radius of curvature, where you can see here the list of five different geometries here analyzed, including the circular, parabolic, elliptical, catenary, and so on. Just some examples among some most common geometrical shapes for structural application, where the circular shape is considered as the reference one. And for an orthotropic curved specimen in mixed mode loading condition, we plot the interfacial stresses first against the dimensionless bonding length for this unprecracked specimen and for different curved geometries. And you can notice the coexistence of a non-null value for both sigma and tau for all the geometries, which confirms the mixed mode interfacial behavior due to the mixed mode loading condition, but not only, due to the geometrical curvature. And you can see also the response, the mechanical response in a kinematic sense, where there are all the kinematic quantities are plotted here for different geometries, and where all the curves reflect the gray sensitivity of the mixed mode behavior to its geometrical shape, where you can see here has the highest stiffness seems to be reached for an elliptic shape, while the lowest stiffness seems to be reached by a parabolic shape. So, I mean, all the other geometries enable intermediate stiffness values, as you can see here in the kinematic response. So for this limit case, I mean, among a large parametric investigations, here I also show you some results obtained by comparing the elliptical shape against the circular one, so the reference one, for different radius of curvature. So while maintaining fixed the length span and varying the values of the rise, where the last value of the rise here considered corresponds to the length mid-span of the curved specimen. So as you can see here, for an increased value of the rise, both stress components maintain almost the same peak value at the crack tip, and decay to zero with an oscillating behavior within a shorter distance from it in a more localized zone. And the effect of the radius of curvature can be seen also here in a static sense and a kinematic sense, where you can see has an increased rise makes the oscillating behavior of the internal action even more localized ahead of the crack tip, where an increased value always of the rise increases the overall deformability of the specimens. Look at here, where in particular you can see also has the bolding lines between both for the elliptic and the circular shape are exactly the same, because at least for the last value of the rise, because in this case the elliptic shape tends to the reverse to the circular one. So we have proved the sensitivity of the response of the delamination response for different curvature and shapes for the curved specimen, which could be, let me say, of great interest for design applications of adhesive joints and curved members. And we have also prove the efficiency of the generalized differential quadrature approach to treat this kind of problems. A possible further extension of the work could include the nonlinear softening branch as typical of a quasi-zone modeling for fracture mechanics problems and possibly to extend to shell structures, this kind of numerical method. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you so much, Rossana. Very, very impressive results. Are there any questions for this paper? No? I have a very quick question. The GDQ method have any problem with certain kind of curvature, for example, very high curvature in your opinion, or you can use... No.
We can use the method is efficient also for high curvatures because I didn't show the wider parametric investigations, but we have also further results about this. With any kind of shape, any kind of curvature, so also high curvatures. Yes.
Okay. And very fast, are you planning to make some experimental test to compare your results to experimental observations?
Yes, why not? Especially because in our university, there is an important laboratory another group really makes this kind of experiments on investigations in an experimental way. So we could check our results also with the experimental results.
Well, thank you so much.